A default pop-up in ArcGIS Pro consists of a single column listing of fields, and if the layer has image attachments, an image element is added. You can configure your pop-up to add, remove, or modify elements by right-clicking your layer and in the context menu, clicking on Configure Pop-ups. The Configure Pop-ups pane opens, listing all available elements at the top. I will remove the fields table by clicking on the X on the top right of the fields block, and edit the attachment block by clicking the pencil button to remove the attachment name. When I'm done editing the properties of an element, I can commit my changes by clicking the back arrow to return to the homepage of the Configure Pop-ups pane. Next, I will split the attachment into two horizontally stacked elements and click and drag a text element onto the block on the left to replace the duplicate image. I will edit the text block to include the attraction title and description and change the font style and size. Now, when I click on a feature, my pop-ups will reflect my changes. By default, pop-ups in ArcGIS Pro are divided into two sections by a gray divider, the results tree view listing, and the individual feature attributes. Hovering over the gray divider will reveal three buttons that allow you to collapse one portion or change the pop-up's default vertical orientation. The Hide Top button allows you to hide the tree view listing on the upper part of the pop-up. This option is particularly useful for cases when you want to focus on the feature attributes. The Hide Bottom button will collapse the feature attributes and the tree view listing will fill up the pop-up. The Split Vertically button changes the orientation of the pop-up from vertically to horizontally stacked. Once in a side-by-side configuration, you can similarly collapse the right and left sides. In all states, you are able to click and drag the divider bar to change the size of each side, as well as to reveal a hidden portion. These features allow you to customize how you view and interact with pop-ups in ArcGIS Pro. When configuring your pop-ups in ArcGIS Pro, you might choose to split your elements. With the element block selected, you can choose to split it into two horizontally stacked elements or two vertically stacked elements. Once you've split your element, you can click and drag a different element to replace the duplicate. You have the option to rotate selected elements to the left by 90 degrees. This option converts a single row of multiple elements into multiple rows of individual elements, as well as multiple rows of elements into a single row. You can also choose the horizontal arrangement proportions from a drop-down list. It's worth noting that an element cannot be divided into a width smaller than 25% or 1/4 of the row. If any of the selected elements doesn't have enough space, the split horizontal command will be unavailable. Did you know that in ArcGIS Pro, you can pin one or multiple pop-ups to the screen so they don't disappear when you click a different one? Pinning pop-ups is a great way to do a side-by-side feature pop-up comparison, or if you work with dual or large monitors and like to spread out your application display. To pin a pop-up, right-click it in the pop-up results tree and click Move to Pin Pop-up. The pop-up remains pinned until you either return it to the pop-up pane using the Move to Pop-up Pane button on the pop-up banner or close the pop-up. It's worth noting that closing the pop-up removes it from the listing entirely. It will not return to the primary pop-up pane. You can collapse a pinned pop-up to minimize its appearance in the view. Then, only the pop-up banner remains with the Move to Pop-up pane, expand, and close options. A default pop-up in ArcGIS Pro consists of a single column listing of fields, and if the layer has image attachments, an image element is added. For features with more than one attachment, you can choose to limit the attachment's display by checking the Display Most Recent Image Only checkbox, or you can flip through the different attachments using the arrows in the pop-up. For layers with enabled attachments, you can display the list of attachments in the pop-up by checking the Show List of Attachments checkbox at the bottom of the Configure Pop-ups pane. Once enabled, the pop-up lists hyperlinks that open each attachment in the default file handler. If you display a pop-up for a feature that does not have an associated attachment when the Show List of Attachments option has been checked, a message appears in the pop-up, indicating that no attachments were found. When configuring your pop-ups, you can customize most elements using HTML. To enable HTML mode, turn on the HTML mode toggle at the top of a pop-up element when editing. When you enable HTML mode for a field element, the information is converted to a text element that is pre-populated with a table containing the list of visible fields. When turning HTML mode on, you will get a warning explaining that it's not possible for text elements to go back to field elements. With all element types, switching to non-HTML mode will lose all HTML formatting, so you will be prompted to confirm this action with a warning. It's worth noting that only a list of select HTML tags are supported in pop-ups. You can access this information at any time on the Configure Pop-ups page of the ArcGIS Pro documentation.